pull it this way, because we have to clear the stock to the city.
But you twist and pull this way.
Yeah. Sitting on blocks, it means we'll have to split this part and move it away. It's not too heavy anymore.
Unfortunately, as you can see, we didn't have enough clearance for the engine to come out forward all the way just because of this gasket side of the block, and we have this frame rail, and yeah, didn't come out, and we have to clear out the studs, still a half an inch. Hope for the best, didn't work out. Anyway, not a big of a deal at all. Try to do the easiest as possible way, but we're going to drop the propeller shaft, drive shaft, going to remove those bolts around the transfer case housing, drop that puppy down, pull the shaft out, and then we'll remove our front loader towers, the brackets, and that way we can just roll the front axle away and we still have engine supported. Not a big of a deal. And to the wrench, let's drain oil first of the transmission before removing the housing. All the sump coming out. Ah, here we go. Look at that. Ooh, ugly gear oil mixed with the water. Milkshake. Look at that. Yeah. Well, definitely contaminated. We have to drain. Yeah. It's a hydraulic oil, sorry. It's not a gear oil. Yeah. Anyway, let the oil to drain. Check it out. We have a red gasket maker, and it means someone was taking this transfer case housing apart already, because this is not from the factory or here, where the transmission matches the rear end. We have a factory silicone, and all it was oversprayed with a gray paint. Yeah, all right, something interesting. Torn apart at some point. Almost drained all oil. It's creamy and it's contaminated. Yeah, alright, almost ready to pop the housing. Pulling the shaft out, let's do the reference mark between the shaft and the splines. Something like that. Yeah, let's remove those bolts. 12 mil dual pick socket. Here we go. Last bolt is removed. Let's pry the housing down. Okay, she's cracked. A little bit of oil might come out. Just carefully pry more. She's not. Oh, there we go. Nice. I notice there's a jam spring fall off. There's a shifter. Yeah. Alright. Let's pull it off. Okay, here we go. Ah, nice. Well, this transfer case will need a good cleanup. The spring needs to be replaced. It was sitting here. As you can see, it mingled. Jammed, definitely. No go. And yeah. So far, so good. No broken, missing teeth. No metal, just a yogurt. Transfer case and transfer case mounting bolts are in a Ziploc bag for the next future cleanup and reassembly. Good to go. I will leave a drain pan underneath. It will keep dripping for some time. So transmission there. Let's pull the shaft. Rust. There we go. Yeah, that was our shaft. Shaft and the sleeve are coming out. The shaft. Yeah. It's all in grease. It's all rusted. It's not a high speed velocity shaft. Shouldn't be a problem. Yeah. Alright, one step at a time. We have a shaft disconnected. Now I will just remove front loader bracket bolts and yeah, it should be all good. 24 mil socket to remove big bell housing bolts. Yeah, I'm going to disconnect 6 bolts on each side. I will leave those ones in place and we'll drag this dolly as one piece with the brackets. Yeah, that's what I think. Should be easy that way. And that way we don't have to undo those parts and yeah, less things to assemble later, okay? I'll just bring them loose. Okay, 6 bolts are removed. 2 on the bottom, you can see. And they're the same length, bottom one is shorter. Let's pull the spacer out. We don't need it. There we go. That's a spacer. And I have my tractor sitting on blocks, and also I have a blocks supporting the front loader part. Yeah, all right, it's kind of easy. You know what? Let's undo those two, then get it out of the way. It will be easy to move it around. Bottom block is removed, 2 bolts, and yeah, as you can see here. Like we, you can see here, the bolts for the back side, bottom ones, and the front. And I have one bolt temporarily holding this bracket from falling down. And yeah, now I can take the bolt out and put the bracket and carry it away. Pull the bolt out. Well, for better, we're doing a surgery. This structure will be better as new. Okay, I'll carry this one away. We'll move to the right side. Beautiful. There we go. I have one bolt partially holding. Going to the front. Rigid power. Beautiful. Right on. Nice.
Okay, buggy is out of the way. Wasn't that difficult. Easy peasy. And now we're straight ready for the pull the engine out. That'll be a good deal. Let's grab our handy pry bar. Try to get it out. There we go. Now we're talking. It's coming. Is that ring gear? The flywheel? Around. Pull on the other side. Okay. Here we go. The transmission to the flywheel. Yeah. Oh no. Over here we can see the engine model and displacement, and 844L 2.2 liters Shibaura. Yeah, Shibaura engine is nice and clean, almost looking at brand new, but still doesn't burn. 360. Well, the next part will be doing a disassembly and find it out why we cannot turn this engine 360. I guess, well, because we have a problem with the connecting rod or crankshaft itself. We'll find it out pretty soon. Stay tuned and see you soon. Yeah, thank you so much guys for watching this video. Appreciated that, and yeah, take care. Bye bye.